Offices of Displace International, Midtown Manhattan, New York City, USA. Displace International has been protecting Zerkheizi, who contacted the server to kidnap Morgan Holt. Contracted. It must be determined if Displace is merely protecting Zerkheizi or if they are also involved in the plot to acquire the Mars girls. Greetings, fellows. Welcome back to Splinter Cell Chaos Theory as a field interrogator. We are continuing with the story, obviously. And thus far, we have figured out that there was another computational scientist called Zerkheizi who has been, who essentially more or less hired some goons to kidnap and torture another computational scientist working at the Moscow, known as Bruce Morgenholt. Now, Radius apartment gives us a connection to Displace because he was being protected by Displace. Now the question stands whether Displace is actually protecting Zerkheizi. You know, of their own volition, or whether somebody within the space is playing them. And to figure that out, we are actually going to the offices of Displace International to essentially access their servers and find any kind of evidence about who's pulling the strings behind the scenes here. Sam is sort of unwilling to believe that his friend might be crooked, but he wants to tell Shetland about everything. He wants to instruct Shetland to let some people go so that to maintain security, essentially. However, operational security takes precedence. The NSA's Third Echelon initiative cannot let him do that, and for good reason as well, because if he does step off Shetland and Shetland is in fact involved in all of this, then he might just go ahead and hide all the evidence. Or take a step back into the shadows and make it even more difficult to catch him. So, with that being said, let us go ahead and begin this interview.
Now coming to you from our New York City Broadcast Center, we have Patrick Dunn of Watershed Electric on the line. Mr. Dunn, what do we know at this moment?
All we know so far is that this was not an accident.
If it's not an accident, then it must be intentional. Both us and the Japanese have been hit by this thing. I think it's pretty obvious who's responsible.
Here's a Tomo.
It appears we have something in common, Admiral.
Our analysis of the information footprint shows that the pressures which collapsed our power grids appear in many ways similar to those that collapsed our markets. I am certain the Koreans and the Chinese are involved.
Let's not jump the gun here, Admiral. We've had our microscope on a man named Zerkheizi. He had access to weaponized IW algos following that business in Georgia. He was also a major DOE consultant after the blackouts here in 2003.
Yes, we are aware of this connection. Has Zerkheizi been found?
Not yet, but it won't take long. I'll keep you posted.
Fisher, I'm afraid we might be facing an orchestrated attempt to push the world into a major crisis. Zerkheizi might know more about information warfare than anyone on Earth, and the fact that this place is combat-ready, essentially stateless, and better equipped than most governments, we need to find out fast whether this is a coincidence or whether someone inside this place is making a major move. That said, State Department has several very significant contracts with this place. This thing is extremely political. I hate to do this to you, but keep it clean. Recon only, no fatalities.
Displace's offices are on the top three floors of the Hans Center Tower in downtown Manhattan. Recent financials indicate that they have invested heavily in their local infrastructure in order to maintain full operational capacity following even a major terrorist incident.
Satellite confirms Grimm's data. Displace is up and running at near to full capacity. It looks like they might be holding a meeting with members of New York City Council, possibly making a bid for protection or policing services to supplement the National Guard. They're prepared and opportunistic, that's for sure. But I wouldn't expect anything different. My money says they're playing fair, but if the boss wants to take a closer look, then that's what we'll do.
Good job. You heard my talk. So, just to make this clear, I am planning to go in and interrogate as many people as possible. And that's what this playthrough is about, in case you're new to this playthrough and you've had any doubts about it.
Fisher, we need to find out if Displace and Zerkheizi are working together.
But until we know, you want me to keep it quiet.
Don't kill anyone or I'll abort the mission. The Pentagon has contracts with Displace all around the world. The president will have puppies if he finds out we're doing this.
Have puppies. I wonder what that means.
Hey, Marco asked me to ask you when you'd be finished getting the ventilation system.
I don't know. You know why?
Well, Marco says hurry up. He says the air is getting stale inside.
What the hell do I care what Marco says? I don't even know him.
I'll tell him you said that.
Go ahead.
Boy, are you in trouble.
Whatever.
What are these Marco voices? Alright, come on then. I didn't get a move on, which is a secret I can grab you. I have you. So tell me, what do you know?
Something going on with the ventilation system?
Hey, who are you?
Pretend I'm Harry Tuttle.
Who?
I'm an ill-tempered and heavily armed heating engineer who's asking questions about your ventilation system.
Heating engineer. I guess it's not working properly since the blackout.
So it shouldn't take much to shut down that big fan if I wanted to.
I don't know. Why would you want to do that?
The adventure. The travel.
Okay. And don't forget to fill out your 26-7B stroke 6.
What? What's that?
I don't care what you do with the fan. Just don't kill me.
Oh, he actually thinks he is a heating engineer. Alright then. Your turn. I'll wait for you to come here. Or maybe not. This is going to try to grab you. Do you know anything? Of course you don't. It's a good thing this thing isn't electrocuted or like electrified this fast. Alright. I'll figure and do you need to pick a panel like break the lock or something? That's it. I do actually need to pick it. No need to worry, Sam. There's nobody around to watch you. And, oh yeah, right. I need to open this up first. And then can I rattle down this side? I do not need to do that. I should probably put my light vision on because I cannot see anything right here. Which means that you guys probably won't be able to see anything right here either. I'm moving slowly to avoid making sounds.
You're certainly entitled to request protection at that level from the National Guard, I agree. But let's face it, the National Guard is a massive, cumbersome organization.
Sure, that's what we need, a presence.
On the contrary, the people want protection, they need protection, but they don't want to see protection. It frightens them. Having the National Guard on every corner will keep the peace, but at what cost?
They'll get over it, Julian. In the end, the thing they'll remember is that the National Guard is cheap. I'm dealing with taxpayers here. The last thing I need is another fiscal accountability scandal. What?
Come on, I want to show you something.
Right. No, I wonder if I can ever grab any of these two guys and make them talk. Squeal, so to speak.
Fisher, that executive.
Oops.
He probably has the daily access algorithm for the Displace Central servers stored on his laptop.
Lambert gave me pretty strict non-lethal parameters.
If you stay close, you should be able to hack into his laptop wirelessly.
I'll give it a whirl.
Is someone moving around out there? Who?
Don't you
know who, that's why I'm worried.
Come on, I'll grab one of the boots and then the other.
Oh.
Hey, are you okay?
He's alright. Not in harm's way, right? We're just a little preoccupied for the moment. Answering questions.
Is New York City thinking about hiring Displace to protect Manhattan?
Yeah.
As far as PMCs go, Displace isn't so bad. But you have no idea what you're getting into.
What do you mean?
Remember the Mafia?
Yeah, well, I've heard stories.
Well, imagine if instead of a bunch of thick-necked goons with stilettos, the city was indebted to an army of sociopathic snake-eaters who were loyal to the highest bidder.
That doesn't sound good!
It wasn't the barbarians who sacked Rome. It was the legionnaire expatriates who mustered barbarian armies.
They're scaring me!
Get out while you can.
Look at Sam talking philosophy.
Please! I'm just an elected official. I have no real power.
I thought this was closed.
Oh, yeah. I totally forgot to turn the...
Hello?
I totally forgot to close the door on my bar. That is... Well, actually, it's not that bad, to be honest. My bar is in the shadows. It should not be found as easily. Now, the other guy, he more or less ran, dropping his laptop actually, so I'll just go ahead and I'll try to close the door again. Alright, let's check out this side, right?
Nothing here but ghosts and shadows.
Indeed. What do you have to say? Are you the only one that has talked to the other guy? I do not think so. You seem to be just about.
Gotcha. Now give me the server access algorithm.
I can't!
What do you mean you can't?
The algorithm is several thousand characters long! It's encoded on my laptop, and on a server near the lobby.
Oh. How do I get there?
The door code to the lobby is 8136.
Thanks.
God, please, don't hurt me.
Right, that was beautiful.
Well, I guess that's one way to deal with it.
Finesse is for the young and the cocky.
Sam also says that if any time you just essentially knock the boot out, Sam always say that.
Fresh ground or dried?
What?
The coffee machine. Ground or dried?
I'm not sure.
Then you better tell me something useful and fast.
You might need the door code out of here. It's 8136.
That'll do.
Do you like cream and sugar with that?
How do I say so, young? I don't, but it should.
Anything that this computer has to offer, of course not.
Try our new rejuvenating formula. You'll look younger, feel younger.
I just think this body be here. Yeah, we call this the operations room.
Sam, each of Displace's different divisions seem to have their own server farm. I put a program on your opsat that will build a little back door into their networks.
You want me to upload that to each division server?
I would appreciate it.
Since you ask so nice.
Right then. So, since I'm playing it on, normal, I should not have any problem infiltrating from this side. Just that there's a guy up there that I'm rather not to be cautious of. Maybe I could do it with him. Maybe, just maybe.
Hey!
And instead of waiting around all the time, might as well go ahead and put a jump on him. Look at that guy climbing down the stairs. the animation is... This is head on backwards. I'm gonna grab him like this though. Well, you had an on street now. But unfortunately for you, you're nothing. You are another chance now. Alright then. This piece is division with server, I believe, which was that computer over there. And then we could save you before I attempt to hack this. Sometimes a hacking minigame does not work like it is supposed to. Last number would be 20. The only one that's there.
Good work, Sam. That's the first of their servers. If you can upload that to each of the other ones, I'll be able to snoop around as much as I please.
I'll see what I can do.
Right then. And we head to... Well, the critical part. We head back to the critical part. This is more of a detour. Strange. Anyway. 8146. 8136. Nice. Anybody across on the other side? Do not think so. I keep forgetting that you have to close doors in this game. I wonder if there's anything on that computer. I'd like to check, but I just want to take the card over there first. There's the card. I can hear sounds to my right, but I can't see the guard. Ah, there he is. Not bad, lad. Come on then, don't be shy. No, I'm not chopping down because I don't want to step into a smash pipe, but... Should I just go ahead and get behind him or something? Might as well try, I suppose. Ooh, that was close. That was close. I wonder what I can switch off from here. Hi there. What do you have for me? Nothing? Alright, we don't need to go to sleep. We got it. No issues whatsoever. Alright then. Over on this side, I saw the option to switch something off from you. Oh, right, the glass tools here. I went to know if Sam did to comment on how it was freaky like it typically does. Whatever that happens, I mean. Okay, let's go out of this loop here. Switch shoulders. Where's the keypad? Right then. The keypad code? I do not have that. That is sad. 68. This is 40. It's 10. Well, that was lucky.
Small problem, Sam. Hurry up. A couple staffers got locked between the double doors leading to the server room.
The kind of makes it hard to get through.
Yeah. There might be another way. Looks like there are some heat exchange vents in this part of the building. You might be able to find a way out there if you head through the R&D section.
I'll snoop around.
So this is the part of the game where it sort of loses its immersion temporarily because the game more or less forces you to go through the vents instead of letting you just approach the objective through this gate. Although you could probably do that to the exit, but for now you cannot approach the objective through the gate. You have to instead rely on using the vents instead. Ah yes, this computer. I wonder if it had something. Security access on it. Just that. Just any security access just across the camera, I suppose. It could be kept hidden behind a layer of security, as is appropriate. I don't see anything wrong with that. Not in this section. every little sound and detail that this game has to offer. It's so part of this rich saving, which is simply a good spot. I did not think walking around here might be difficult. It did not pose a problem whatsoever. But it's even better to go to the toilet. All right, take a moment. I'll go and grab it first. Sam likes to grab people while they're taking a moment, doesn't he? So, what do you mean? Sorry, well, we can talk to you.
How do I access the main server room?
You can't get through here. Our doors are malfunctioning.
Is there another way?
Maybe through R&D. Might be a way through the ventilation into the server room.
Thanks.
Looks to me like the meeting rooms are all clear.
Now, I could make use of it inside.
Starting identification. Retinal prints valid.
Nothing. I'll just keep it in the body right here. I wonder what that is.
I cooperated! Please!
Alright. Your body will be useful to me later, but this is the reason why I'm keeping it here. First, I will come out. And I will use people over here. When I go 66. It's not 20. It's not 30. It's the last for this one. Just camera access, nothing else. Alright. Moving on. I love the music in this game. Have you ever told you guys that? The music in this game is just so amazing. No. Oh, well. Ah, you've already gone past me. That was easy, because this part typically is not as easy to grab this guy. Although he does not have him to say so. Now I've never grabbed this guy, so I'm just gonna go to try to do that. What flights are those? Ah, all the pieces with displays actually were for operations, I see. Now how did Sam get on top of that without knocking his teeth out of the bosses? You don't have to harder. Let us keep it that way. I just wanna go ahead and check out what all these computers have to offer. Seven. Is that 192? Not 30, 30. 20. That's 193. And it's not 10, so it must be 20.
Good work, Sam. Upload that program to the last server and you'll make me the happiest girl in the world.
You're easy to please.
Access is a girl's best friend. Okay, we have the access algorithm. Now we can access the central server on the first floor.
I'll find it.
Cool. I sort of forgot to check out the computers in that room next year. Yeah. It's something the same magnate Brody Masterson Woods III yesterday announced the winner of the $1.1 billion stupid ball lotto, the largest jackpot in US history. He already has a net worth of 68.4 billion. the one person who does not make the money wins it. We've completed a technical evaluation of our outside generators. We expect limited power access to the entire building and have upgraded the surge protection to protect the building when city restores the power. We expect the immediate restoration of all systems without interrupt. What about these computers? Do these have anything? National Guard stress test. Defense Secretary Frank Mason was quoted. That's the mustached guy that, you know, usually appears in the cinematics, by the way. Frank Mason was quoted as saying the National Guard was stretched impossibly thin, with National Guards being supplemented regular U.S. Army forces in 11 countries overseas. Damn! The recent emergency departments in 5 states have seriously impaired their ability to defend the people. I still don't get the National Guard. It's like a voluntary service with, you can also go abroad, like you're deployed abroad. I thought it was just more like something for, national defense, but apparently not. So typically I can take that point over there, but I'm not really going to take it right now. Oh, I get this, left this door open again. My bad. No, he's not a dude. Do you know why? Because he's unconscious. I mean, he is comparatively okay, but just not okay in the traditional sense of the word. What is this? His body's right here. Why did you guys come back on?
It's a pretty cushy posting, that's for sure. But I heard the guy was really annoying.
The guy isn't there anymore. He's out of town.
What, so you're just watching his stuff?
Yeah, emptying his liquor cabinet and playing video games. He's got the new Prince of Persia.
Yeah, I heard it's awesome.
Gonna be game of the year, man.
Can't wait to play it.
Alright. I'm just gonna go and get the W right now.
Still there? What?
No, I don't think he's still here. He's just taking the view back, is all. He didn't just do it probably even so before. Sometimes the folks just, oh no. Safe for now, at least. Well, I guess that's going to be to do with you as well. Now then, you too. Do you know anything? Of course you don't. Why would you? It's like nobody knows a thing here. You're all useless to a lot of people. I guess that was the guy at the bottom of the stairs there. I should probably save, but let's go and save. I don't know whether I'm digging a hole for myself or not when I'm doing this, but whatever. That's a test turret, and that's where the turrets are being tested. I believe it is this computer that I need to have. 20 and 91, 66, obviously. That's a bonus objective. Oddly enough, though, they do not actually tell you, like, the crew doesn't exactly congratulate you, or there's no additional dialogue prompted whenever this happens. Oh, I guess that was the guy who goes upstairs, right there. So I suppose we are free to explore again. Well, there's this matter of, you can access it through there as well. Let me just go and hack this computer. Power system evaluation, we have already done that.
There's got to be a way through to the server room from this area.
Firing ranges usually have ventilation to clear the smoke. It probably ties into the AC system in the server room.
Good thinking.
Right. So I'm guessing they're testing the penetration ability of that turret there. Because pilots would be putting the bulletproof glass in front of it, if not. So this is the crawl space that we can use to get into the one of these servers, essentially. We don't need to hack this, and it creates one less suspicion for us. Around 230. Yeah, only have another 30 at the end.
Thanks, Sam. That's the last one. I can't wait to sniff around and displace his laundry basket. What?
Laundry. I totally forgot.
And Sam has his priority street, so he's in a very dense mission about the future of the country. And he's talking about laundry. Now, this should not be a way we might be able to mess this up, but...
Got it all sorted out.
Damn door.
Right, it takes a while.
Damn. It looks like someone has shunted the data we need off the server. Login name M. Nedich.
Mylon Nedich?
That name is coming up an awful lot, but we still don't have anything on him.
Probably a pseudonym. I'll see if I can find out who he really is.
In any case, we need to get access to his computer. His office should be on the upper floor somewhere.
Sorry to interrupt, but...
I see it.
Power's coming back on.
I see it, Grim.
You got company. You might want to...
I see it.
Want to check the server and make sure nothing got fried when the power came back on.
Okay. Give a shout if you need anything.
Will do.
Now I'm gonna try and crack this guy. The issue is, as soon as he walks in, he decides to make all the glasses transparent. Actually, they're not transparent, that's good. That is good.
I had a bit of a problem with your server.
Please, don't kill me!
The files I want got shunted off to another computer.
There should be a backup here.
There isn't. They're only on the PC of Mylon Nedich.
Mylon? He's the VP of Protection Operations. His office is on the upper floors.
Don't you think it's suspicious that he's hiding files?
Yeah, I guess. Please, please let me live.
All right, I'll let you live. I'll just knock you off, though. That was feasible. Now, as for this guy, whatever he is, I cannot see through this glass either. What a bit. Oh, right there. Almost did not see him there. But he does not really have anything to say for himself either. Might as well just shoot him off later. Sam brings that close, set the mighty close people. Maybe the two close would not fit, if you know what I'm saying. I guess he called me too. Oh, right. So this is big game. The first stage of that people more or less stuck. And that camera out there, we need to do something about it. Actually, no. We don't really need to do anything about it.
First floor.
Can I just go in here? No? Okay, I'll just take this camera out just for a second.
First floor.
Right. Took a bar. I left a body in the wrong place.
I've been hearing some creepy stuff about Mylon. I'm sure I trust him.
Yeah. I heard he got drunk with some of the guys in the temple last month, wandered out of the bar looking for a fight. They found him the next morning, covered in blood.
What?
Yeah. Stan thinks he killed someone. Read a newspaper article the next day. Istanbul police found some guy cut to ribbons just a couple of blocks from the bar they were at.
Whoa.
I think we should try and get on his PC in the executive offices. See if we can find anything.
The code to the area is 2346, but I don't know the code for his actual office.
All right. Well, if I find out what it is, we'll go together.
All right.
The small one just seems to be pretty full. All right, then. I'm grabbing a few. You get a big fish finger. I guess obviously we'll be wanting to go with this guy, so since it would be easier to drag to the corner. Okay. I suppose nobody's gonna be looking at me, so might as well.
Gotcha.
Hey! You're not supposed to be here!
Tell me something useful and I'll leave.
Forget it! I won't tell you anything!
Are you crazy? We're on the 60th floor.
What? What do you mean?
You know, it's not true that you go unconscious before you hit the ground.
Oh, damn.
You see it coming the whole way.
Oh, shit.
You wouldn't!
You want to convince me not to?
Door code to the executive offices is 2346. Please! I'm scared of heights!
Alright, I'll leave it be. Since you are scared of heights and all. Should I chance if I die one time? I suppose so. Since this guy does not seem to have an issue. I'm just sort of hoping that I can get to catch him before he goes all the way in there. Get over here. Of course, you don't know anything else. I mean, I just did it to meet your buddy. And it would be a travesty if you need to know more than that. So, then. I've actually gone around and...
You're so late. We need to put some extra men on the Zerkheizi detail. Your name came up.
Zerkheizi? The wacko in the penthouse uptown?
Well, it's perhaps best not to refer to our client as the wacko, but yes, him. Or rather, his penthouse. Milos Nowak is,
Who?
Milan. Milan Nedich. Crazy Slavic names. I always get them confused. Anyway, Zerkheizi is out of town, so there won't be a VIP, just the property.
Okay. Sounds like a breeze.
Well, it hasn't gone perfectly smooth so far. You'll get the full VIP rate, and you'll be on duty as though there is a package on site.
Okay, got it.
Good. You report at 1300 tomorrow.
Okay, I'll be there.
Good grab, Fisher. Milan Nedich's real name? Jesus. Milos Nowak.
Milos Nowak? Who is he?
The barber of Bosnia. Suspected war criminal from the Bosnian conflict. Allegedly scalped some of his prisoners.
Wanted in The Hague?
Yeah.
Bet you dollars the dinars that he doesn't make it to trial.
That's okay. I think my money's safer on the Nikkei.
There's something going on out there.
Worth worrying about.
Yeah, but even so.
The issue is the other guy standing right there. Yeah, let's just go and do this. No, you don't get to go all the way there. Of course, you don't know that. It's sort of strange. I mean, I wish they would have left a mechanism in which we could just interrogate the information out of these cards in case. We failed to record the conversation taking place between the super folks here. But this game does not have any such mechanism in place. Now, even if I grab this guy, he will know nothing, even though he was telling the other guy about. Well, you will know that. On Milan Nedic, the Bosnian barber. Or the Bosnian barber. The barber of Bosnia, however you would like to put it. Anyhow, moving on. We need to take this camera out. What's the people? 2346. Hold on. That's good. same guy. Now, we will get the code for that room from this guy. Actually, we can just keep him right here. It's strange how similar all of the headhunters look.
Nice suit. Italian?
Oh no! Italian. Yes, the Florentine silk. Andretti?
Who's Andretti?
Andretti? The famous designer. Men's suits, tuxedos.
I'm not a tuxedo kind of guy.
But you are some kind of spy.
Yeah, I'm the real kind. Not the tuxedo kind. I'm the kind of spy who gets blood all over your Andretti unless you give me information.
Oh, shit.
Oh, God. Please, don't ruin my suit.
How about a door code?
CEO's office, 2609. My wife will kill me if I ruin this suit.
You put that before the pit kills you.
My wife will kill me if...
Oh, man. The interrogations of this game are fun. And that's pretty much the entire reason that I wanted to play it in a way where I interrogate everybody. Okay, what's the code again? 2609, right? Is essentially what a master
Hokkaido.
Plan.
Hokkaido? Isn't that basically the Alaska of Japan?
Yeah. Looks like Mylon Nedich has secretly relocated Zerkheizi there.
Interesting. Now we definitely need to talk to Shetland.
We'll let State Department handle that mess. You're going to Hokkaido. We're sending a helicopter to evac you from the roof.
That's a lot of notes, a lot of notes. The official enters the case as a masked room, I mean, essentially knocks everybody out, intimidates people. All over the place. Now then. Did you see the way once more? I'll just keep that door open for being people to have easier access to the restricted area with their new business going. And with that, everybody in, this piece is knocked out. And all our objectives have been accomplished. 3, 4, 8, 5. This is what I like about this up. The fact that, especially Chaos Theory, the fact that you can play it as you want to, however you want to, with no issues whatsoever. Alright then. That's the end of the game for us. That is a mission at least for us. Now, we've been still trying to figure out who exactly it was that, was pulling the strings at Displace. However, that information has been removed from the Displace servers, probably as a measure of security. However, we've managed to figure out who Milos Novak really is, or Mylon Nedich really is. It is apparently Milos Novak, a wanted war criminal, which makes his character look even shadier. However, we still don't know just how officially this entire fiasco is sanctioned, as far as this piece is concerned. Anyway. Now, the good thing is that I could actually go ahead and capture my secondary objective in this run through. Otherwise, it would have been like, pretty ugly otherwise. If the game was still played by the bug that I had faced the previous time around. This time around, I actually uninstalled the game and reinstalled all of its contents so that I could play it better. We don't have that bug anymore. Hopefully, it will be the same for both houses as well, and I'll get to try the thing that I was planning to try out the previous time around, which I could not. So, I'll be looking forward to that. One civil knocked out, which is the politician, of course, and 19 enemies knocked out, 20 people in total. 38 minutes long. Didn't take too long for me, actually. And that was that for this mission. We have figured out that they are apparently going to be meeting Displace, or at least Mylon Milos Novak is going to be meeting Zerkheizi in Hokkaido. So, yeah, we go to Hokkaido next. And we try and figure out who's really behind all of this. And more importantly, whether Shetland is actually involved in this or not, as things seem to be, or whether it's actually, you know, Milo Nedic who's pulling the strings. Because thus far, there was an element of confusion. How do I put this? A benefit of the doubt to be given to this place, wherein we didn't exactly know whether this was just a coincidence or something intentional, whether this place was playing a part in this or not, but since the data has been shunted off the server, that it has actually been hidden from, you know, falling into the right hands, if we can safely, you know, conclude that this place is actually involved in this willingly. However, we don't know whether it's a data corporation that is corrupted or just that one guy who's played both sides for his own personal gain, Displace and Zerkheizi, to obtain the mask owners. So, yeah, that's that for Mission Displace. The next time I come back, we will meet you in Japan, in Hokkaido, Sapporo, apparently, outside Sapporo. So, until then. Thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, thank you for sticking around until the end. Take care. Fear the bell for those things.